Welcome in, everyone, to a new series here on Grandpa's Farm. This series is based in the 1980s. It's based on real-life equipment that was used on my grandpa's real-life farm in northern Missouri. I'm really excited about this new series. I hope you enjoy watching it as much as I'm going to enjoy making it. Let's get started.
Welcome to the 1980s in a rural farm in northern Missouri, Grandpa's Farm.
Yeehaw! We're going to start by giving a quick little tour. This is the double wide the family lives in. Grandma's garden out to the side with a little pond. Now this land's been kind of let down over the years. And we're going to turn this, what used to be a field over here, back into a field. That's one of the projects we're going to be working on. Up here is the cattle operation. We're going to have to work our way up to having cattle. Where all that overgrowth is across the road, we're going to mow that first so we can get some hay for the cattle. And out back, we have an old barn. This is the stuff we're starting with. All I have is this old Ford. $20,000 in the bank. Well, we do have Minneapolis Moline equipment, an old sickle mower. Now this baler is not what we would have had in the 80s. It was the closest thing I could find to what real life equipment was. And we have a Deutz. The Deutz tractors actually came in the late 80s, early 90s. 13-06 is what we had on the farm. This was an Oliver tractor that was used on the farm. Did most of the planting work. Now this is a white 2110. On the real farm it was a white 2105, which was not available in the mod hub. And then the Kinsey planter actually did not come around till the 90s either. But it's going to be what we use because it was all white farm equipment back then, and I couldn't find a white planter to use. So let's get started by tilling up. Actually, we're going to mow up the field across the road. So let's grab a tractor and get going. I'm really glad the times have changed. Advanced past the sickle mowers. A little bit slow with the job. Not very big. But they were easy to keep up. Easy to fix. Get this mowed up. Just so you know how long it's been since this has been a field, we actually have a tree that's grown up in it. One of these days we're going to have to come back here and cut this tree down. Kind of change a few teeth on this mower. With all the brush cutting through. It's mowing up nicely. Not much left. Last little bit, and we'll head back to the house. And hopefully by morning, it's dried up enough, we can get it baled up into hay. It's not really a hay field. Not fertilized or anything. It's going to produce something. Something for Grandpa's farm. Oh, got the mower put away. Go ahead and sleep till morning. See if the grass dries. Let's see. Yeah, it looks like it's all dried up nicely. Should be able to get the rake out and get this thing raked up. Grab the little Moleen and do it. The way this tractor sounds. Take a little while, but I think we'll rake the rows together. We'll have to go around as many times as failing. Love some of the simplified equipment. It does look nice. Get to rake. Got the raking just about wrapped up at this point. After the clean. Kind of a slow process. Doesn't even make the prettiest windrows. Decided just to rake two rows to the middle. Make the baling process go a little quicker. Last little bit here. If you've ever driven a Minneapolis Moline tractor, sure, put something in the comments about what tractor, what model, or maybe it was a combine. They make some nice combines, or they did make nice combines at one point. I did rake with a little tractor like this, but I don't know if this was the model. What model it was. Extra heavy because there are about three rows raked together. Let's take over the barn and pick up Baylor. It does sound nice. We'll take the white out today. Little case round baler. I like to do little square bales, but they're gonna take a long time. No. Baler only makes the small round bales. I think we are going to have a lot of hay coming. Continue on. Just another bale or two and we'll have this all wrapped up. Now our pickup wagon we have, it's kind of a, it's definitely not an auto loader. We have to line up four bales in a row and then back under this set of bales. As soon as we get this done, I'll start lining up four to a bundle. Over 60 bales here, though. We'll just leave half the bales out here on the other side of the field. I think we're only going to use half of this ground for our corner. There's all of our bales. Our baler put away here. Bale wagon. You see that next to the building. The actual style that my grandpa had, the only thing different is he didn't have the frame on top. It was more of a just low to the ground. I don't think you had to line them all up. Held on for a little while. Nothing to see here. There it is. There. That looks a little more level. perfect of the roads they need to be. Personally, I'd rather just have a bale fork in front and a bale fork on the 3-point. Do it that way. Especially since we're only going across the drive. Not like we even have far. Get done testing out this wagon, we might actually. Four. Go of it. That's four. Back to our wagon. Here. Know what patrol will do. That's better. Go, come on. Come on. There. There it is. Actually, it looks like you get a fifth bale on there. This is only a 4-bale trailer, but fifth would work. Just gotta figure out where we want to put them. Access that. Not too close. Cattle can put their head through. There. Alright, well, we'll get some more. Well, that should be enough bales over here for now. Just pour this down and leave it over here. Alright. Now go grab a plow. We'll use the Deutz tractor for that. Plow anyhow. and width is our planter. Well, this has a weight. Still kind of wobbly. Here we go. We're going to go just over to the tree line. Stay on this side of the tree. Kind of your deciding factor on how big to go. Operating this cloud up. There, we got our first part of the field all filled up. We'll make a good cornfield. Finally got this piece of land back to the way it used to be in row crops. But hey, we were able to get some good hay off of it too. Been in CRP long enough. I believe that'll do it for this episode of Grandpa's Farm in the 1980s. Please stay tuned till the next one where we will get that planted in corn and get some cattle on the farm, and if time permits, maybe we'll even venture down to the south place. Until next time, have a blessed day, and bye-bye.